Hello and greetings from Iceland. Since the eruption is now officially over, I'm going to look at the lava volume that came up from those eight eruptions and speculate a bit about the future, starting with the most recent earthquakes, since whenever we get a magnitude 3+, the comment section starts to shake as well. And we actually got one such earthquake yesterday on the Reykjavik Peninsula in the so-called Sulfur Mountains, where once was industrial-scale sulfur mining operation. But this area is now better known for this fault, where a big earthquake, magnitude 6+, shakes the ground close to the city every 50 years or so. And the last one was in 1969. And the reason why I'm mentioning this now again is that I see this trend for way more earthquakes than usual at the east part of the peninsula. And my question is, are those earthquakes tectonic? Or do they come as a result from the ground displacement by Grindavík? Or is it just a little bit of both? And I can't say, but what I can explain myself is that this region has the thickest landmass on the peninsula. And the obvious reason is that here we have some of the most powerful volcanoes. As for lava production, and it is around here where some of our experts expect some of the next volcanic chapters to take place after Mother Earth is done by Grindavík. And this is also the area that tells us that although we went through this difficult chapter, those events are on Icelandic scale quite small, especially when it comes to the volume of lava. And it was this unfortunate location of those events that brought all this attention, not the size. So let's have a look at that. The first eruption went on for 274 days and produced 150 million cubic meters of lava that accumulated in several valleys and didn't spread so much. And then we got the so-called Merardalir eruption. And those were the good old days, plenty of good seats. But the volcano trail was a bit longer than the first time. So the local search and rescue team was very busy rescuing tourists. But the eruption lasted for only 18 days. So the tourists that didn't make it in time for the show, they were very disappointed. But most importantly, no damage was done. And the new lava field blended almost seamlessly with the first one. And we were thankful for the location, just like when number 3 started by the mountain Little Rútur. And the hiking trail for tourists grew to be even longer. This was 10 kilometers away from the Volcano car park. And this became the last tourist eruption, as we define tourist eruptions. It went on for 26 days and produced 15 million cubic meters of lava. And for some reason that hasn't been fully explained, those three eruptions started with ground uplift by the mountain Þorbjörn in 2020. That would later move to this mountain, Faradalsfjall. And in 2023, the activity moved back and started this vicious cycle that we might still be stuck with, or five eruptions in total now. But not all of them turned into a disaster. Like we have three eruptions that went on for 6 days in total. And it is in fact a bit complicated to see from what eruption some of those lava fields originate from. This is all blending together. And as for the future around here and the ground uplift that has been detected already, there are two stories about that. One is saying that the rate of inflow has been decreasing. So we might have perhaps just one eruption left, but just days ago, there was a viewer saying in the comment section that since the magma chamber, or magma sill under there, has obviously been growing in size, it skews the ground uplift numbers. Or to make this simple, ground uplift numbers are no longer as reliable as they used to be. And I found that comment to be very logical. But there are, however, many GPS stations around that might help our experts to determine the inflow rate. And I'm leaving a link to the page where you can see the ground uplift. But overall, I think it's just too early to say where we are in this process. The seismic unrest has been decreasing a lot around Grindavík, but growing on the east side of the peninsula, and it would not surprise me if something more would snap there soon. I'm, however, not saying that it might be the big one. The Reykjanes Peninsula has been hit with tens of thousands of earthquakes in the last 3 years. And if this fault is indeed ready for the next one might assume that it might have snapped already. But those earthquakes, they could also be moving us closer to the big one. So when I look at the rest of 2024, asking what else could occur, I would not be surprised if seismic activity would be on the rise on the east side of the peninsula. And we might get other eruptions in other systems. But what system? That is hard to say because there are so many volcanoes getting ready or ready already. Like we have been watching this growing tension under Vatnajökull glacier, and we have expected the Grímsvötn volcanic system to erupt for some years now. It is due, but something is holding it back. But I do see increased activity in the mighty Öræfajökull volcano, but not as much as in 2017 though. But something is happening there. And the volcano Askja looks very suspicious. I have seen growing seismic unrest there in the last 2 months. But there might be years until something serious takes place there. And I do also see growing seismic activity along the north part of the plate boundaries. Not just a few pressure points, like we always see, but that doesn't have to mean anything, of course. This is just something that I notice. And Katla volcano was just recently sending us a few fairly big earthquakes. And Katla is a teaser. Like now, we have the so-called summer here in Iceland. Some of the ice on the glacier above the Katla caldera is melting, so the volcano is adapting to less weight. And summer earthquakes, that is quite normal. We can even expect a few bad-smelling floods from under the glacier from time to time. But I feel as Katla is rather peaceful now. It's not the first place I look at when I open the earthquake pages online. And as for Hekla, I have to mention old Hekla. It is, as usual, impossible to figure out at what stage she is. This is the volcano that gives us only 30 minutes notice. And the longer we have to wait between eruptions, the angrier Hekla gets. And Hekla has inflated way more than before the last eruption 24 years ago. So uncertainty is a word when it comes to Hekla, not for the first time. But there is no uncertainty when it comes to my plans for this summer. The weather so far has been miserable. Most of the mountain roads are still closed, but those red lines on the highlands, they should be gone by now on the mountain road map, road.is. So I'm finishing this month, June, with some video production. So it will be July and August when I will be on the move. And my deep will be looked at in 2 days. It has this dull tendency to shut down every now and then without me telling it to do so. I've already replaced a part of the fuel injection system and hoping it's only a minor problem left. So it's a good time to get the car fixed while the weather is dull because I will be doing some highland tours, filming some of the largest volcanic systems in Iceland and whatever goodies I find in our nature. And finally, I have good news. I'm getting close to 100,000 subscribers. From a land with 400,000 inhabitants, and I'm very pleased with those results. I made this into a goal 2 years ago, but I knew that it would take me time. And since I have no time to have a party to celebrate this, I have a video in the making that covers a bit about the history of my channel. And that video goes actually all over the place. It covers my last 2 volcano tours in details, and includes a lot of footage that I cannot squeeze into my regular updates. And after my next video, you will know more about my intentions for the channel, quality rather than quantity. And I will also have to think about the categories I work in. And that video will be online before the end of the month. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.